Recently, Local First started the initiative Good for Grand Rapids. The program brings together and celebrates companies using business as a force for good. Here with me today is the Local First marketing manager, Mieke Stoub, to talk about the initiative and the good things many of our local businesses are doing. Hello, Mieke. Thanks for joining us today.
Hi. Thanks so much for having me.
So when we hear about Good for Grand Rapids, what is that?
So as you said, Good for Grand Rapids is a campaign we launched about a year ago. The overarching goal is to bring together and celebrate companies that are using business as a force for good. And what that means is that they're being good to their employees, they're giving back to their community, they're creating high quality and more jobs for the people that live here.
All right, and how does one assess the level of goodness and the impact that they're having?
Yeah, so we use our quick impact assessment tool. So it's an assessment that people can go online and take. It takes about half an hour to 60 minutes to take. If you're a business owner, if you are close, if you know a lot about the business, you can take the assessment. And it's industry specific. So a restaurant is going to have different questions than a PR company, for example. So the business owners that go in and take it will only have questions that are relevant to them.
All right. And I understand that over 70 different businesses in the Grand Rapids area participated, including many from Wyoming and Kentwood.
Yeah.
Could you tell me what a few of those businesses are?
Yeah. So Daddy's Dough is one of our members, and they participated in the campaign. We were excited to have them at ForkFest last year. We also have JoJo's House of Beauty and Lindo Mexico and Celebration Cinema, which I'm excited to announce are two of our award recipients. So they scored top in their category. So the assessment will give you a measurement. And so Lindo Mexico and Celebration Cinema were two of the companies that scored highest.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Now, exactly what is the benefit for the business for participating in the Good for Grand Rapids?
Right. So a common challenge across industries is talent acquiring and retention. And as we're noticing, the workforce that are entering the workforce, they want to work for a company that they're proud of. So they want to work for a company that pays attention to social issues, that gives back to their community. So we're giving the businesses the tools that they need in order to facilitate that.
All right. Now, exactly, you mentioned the workforce. Is it becoming increasingly more a challenge to find reliable, qualified employees?
We are seeing that. It's a challenge that a lot of our businesses face, a lot of our members face. So we want to do everything we can to attract talent to West Michigan to make our economy stronger.
Okay. And is that part of what the Good for Grand Rapids addresses?
Yeah. Yep. So we, on top of this celebration that we're hosting in March, we also have a series of educational workshops that are coming in that help people, you know, move kindly into a neighborhood, that that help strengthen their sustainability efforts. And so they educate. We bring in experts on those subjects, and they teach business owners and employees how to be better for the community.
Okay. And if someone were interested in participating in this, how would they go about doing that as far as as a business owner?
Yeah. So the first step is to visit our website. There you can access the quick impact assessment tool. It's a free resource that you can log in, you create an account, and you just jump in. You don't have to finish it. You can go back in as much as you want. You can call us and we can walk you through it. And afterwards, it gives you sort of a infographic of your impact. So it'll show areas that you're doing really well in, and it'll show areas that you can also improve upon.
All right. Now, can they access one another's and learn from each other's strengths and weaknesses?
Well, that's something that we hope will grow organically. We have a growing number of B corporations, which is a type of certification that businesses can go through that's a little bit more involved than the quick impact assessment. So we do want to facilitate those partnerships, but it's not necessarily a formal thing yet.
Okay, all yeah. right, but that's what you're launching toward.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so what are some other activities coming up for Local First?
Yeah, so we have, like I said, we have that program series that's coming up. The first three events are up on our website. We also have a mixer coming up. So if you're intimidated by, you know, jumping in for an hour or 2 hour long workshop, you can come and just meet some of the people that have already gone through the assessment and get some feelers out there. So that's coming up in June.
Okay, wonderful. Yeah. All right. So obviously, Local First has been just a tremendous asset to our community.
Thank you. Yes.
Yeah, definitely.
We'd like to think so. Yeah.
And how long have you been up and running in the West Michigan area?
We're celebrating our 15th year as Local First.
Okay, and yeah. I have to believe that there are special events associated with that as well?
Yeah. So this, our annual meeting that we had in January launched, you know, what we're doing for our 15th year of Local First, and we had, this is going to be our third award ceremony. So at the annual meeting in Grand Rapids, we had we had a local legacy award recipient, Reb Roberts, and then on the Lakeshore, we had another annual meeting, and that's where our Local Motion Awards were. So we honored several businesses out on the Lakeshore in Holland. Again, businesses that are using their business as a force for good. So this will wrap up our third and final award ceremony. So we're starting the year out celebrating.
Okay, wonderful. Well, obviously the longevity of Local First speaks to the fact that there are benefits for companies for their participation.
Yeah.
What are they specifically, or a few of them at least?
Sure. So by being a member of Local First, overarchingly you are joining a movement that promises that a local economy is a stronger economy. It keeps more resources in the community, it provides more and better jobs, and so that's the overarching benefit of becoming a member of Local First. We also offer, you know, business education programs such as these, and we also, you know, offer some marketing support. You know, mm-hmm. if businesses are having trouble getting their name out there, we want to help introduce the public to them.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. So supporting local businesses is imperative.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. By shifting $10 a year, or $10 a month, $10 a year, we can create 1,600 jobs.
Mm, amazing. Yeah, mm-hmm. definitely. So we need to get that message out there still
yeah.
more.
Yeah.
yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Very good. Well, we thank you for coming today, Mieke,
yeah.
and sharing this, and we wish you success with the Good for Grand Rapids.
Thank you so much for having us.
All right, you're welcome. All right. For more information about Local First, visit localfirst.com. Thank you.